Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome inside the American Bank Center. It's time for Shreveport Mudbugs Hockey, and I'm Chet Yoder coming to you live once again from the American Bank Center as a good crowd files in on a work night, Thursday night, for Mudbugs Hockey this evening. And we're so glad to have you with us here for Shreveport Mudbugs Hockey. Tonight, the Mudbugs play their first game off the Christmas break, and those games can be tricky, but the Mudbugs came out of that Thanksgiving break on a fire. They've won 7 of 8 since that break, and they'll look to continue and stay on their hot ways this evening as they open up this first of a two-game series against these Corpus Christi Ice Rays. The Mudbugs took on the Ice Rays for a two-game set a couple of weeks ago just before the break, and they swept them, winning 3-1 on Friday and then 5-2 on Saturday. And some of the big contributions. Ryan Burke had 4 points in the series, including 3 assists in that Saturday game. Garrett Steele, red hot. He had a goal in each of those games in the series. He's now got 6 goals in his last 7 games. Logan Haru continues to quietly have a great year as a defenseman. He's got 15 points, as a defenseman, most out of any Mudbug on the team. It was great to see Nick Marino chip in along with Kaysen Musket chipping in big goals there for the Mudbugs. And Hayden Nickel also a big, big night for him on that Saturday tilt as he had 3 points on the night. So glad to have you with us once again. It'll be the Mudbugs and the Ice Rays. This is an Ice Rays team that had to push back their start time. Sylvain Cloutier was running a little bit late on his flight coming back into Corpus Christi, so they decided to push back the game. So we do love that you're staying with us here for tonight's game, and we'll have a 7:30 puck drop scheduled, and then we'll drop the puck then, and we'll hope to get things rocking and rolling. This is a Mudbugs team that has seen goals now up and down their lineup. They're starting to get more contribution. Guys like Jaden Goldie, like I said, Garrett Steele, Ryan Burke now starting to contribute. Eric Vitale now on a nice, decent point streak. He's starting to pick it up. The one guy they're looking to really get going is Jake Mack. If they can get him going, I feel like they feel really good about their chances. Simo Buschler, he's won his last 6 straight starts in net. He'll look to continue this success tonight as he gets the nod between the pipes, but we'll get to that a little later on in our Whataburger starting lineups. We'll have more after these messages. It's the Landers Dodge Jeep Chrysler and Ram pregame show, and you're listening to Shreveport Mudbugs Hockey.
You know, we only get one chance at this thing called life, so why don't we make it count? Hi, I'm Janice Watt with Generational Financial Advisors, and we're here to assist you as a financial advisor and a CPA in making those important life decisions. Starting young, saving, and investing will reward you down the road, but it takes diligence to stay the course because life happens. Buying that first home, adding to your family, and then preparing for college, all of these require a plan. We offer services including investments, life insurance, retirement planning, and long-term disability, just to name a few. We can also assist you in your tax preparation or planning along with small business services. We are an independent brokerage company with access to hundreds of products. Call me at 318-219-4188 or log into gfapartners.com to set up a free consultation. Our offices are located at 8518 Line Avenue, Suite 103 in Shreveport. Come see us and go Bugs!
The Robertson Cup champion Shreveport Mudbugs know big goals lead to big wins. That's why State Farm agent Ben Tolis and his State Farm team are here to help you score a big goal with your home and auto insurance. It's a great call that saves you time and money. So go score the winning goal and score savings by combining your home and auto. It's just another way we're here to help your life go right. Call State Farm agent Ben Tolis today at 318-688-1522. That's 318-688-1522.
As a business owner, you know it's important to stay ahead of your competition to succeed. One dishonest employee providing poor customer service can send your business to the penalty box. DeFatta & Associates has over 20 years of investigative experience that can help you monitor employees and investigate losses that may be keeping you from reaching your goals. Whether you need GPS tracking, investigative shopping, integrity testing, or you're experiencing losses caused by theft, DeFatta & Associates can help. Give them a call at 318-635-9944 or check out their website at DeFattaPI.com for more information.
Welcome back into the Landers Dodge Jeep Chrysler and Ram pregame show. Mudbugs back off the Christmas break, back into play as we close out the year of 2022 with this two-game series against the Corpus Christi IceRays at the American Bank Center. We're joined by Mudbugs associate head coach Michael Hill and coach. Last time out, it was a two-game sweep over Corpus and 3-1 win on Friday, 5-2 win on Saturday. It feels like it was a while ago because we all kind of, you know, we got the ham, we got the pecan pie in our bellies, we got all the gifts. Talk about what was your biggest takeaway from that series?
I think it was a good, consistent 120 minutes for us. That's one thing to build off of going into this weekend here. I know we got a little bit of a refresh and stepped away from the game for about 10 days, and hopefully going into tonight, the guys needed that to kind of do exactly what they kind of been doing the last 10 games here.
And you guys get a little bit healthier as well. Of course, Maxim Sushinsky and Nick Lavassi, a couple of guys that have been out for a little while. Are you able to have them healthy? Talk about what they can provide and how big that is for your team.
Yeah, I think Sush is just a good puck-moving D. He's pretty dynamic on our power play, and he's able to kind of see plays develop really well and defend the right way. And Levy just brings a nice big body to the lineup, and he knows his role really well. He's just kind of a grinder, plays heavy, is on the puck hard, and is able to play a good physical game.
I wanted to ask you about Ryan Burke. He's been a guy that seems to be elevating his game in and game out. He had three assists in that last game against Corpus, had a goal as well on Friday, had a big series. Talk about what you guys really like about Burke the most.
He's able to really slow down the game in the right way. He has a lot of poise with the puck. He's got good vision, good hockey IQ. Burke, he's been playing really good hockey lately and been getting rewarded with his point production. For what he brings to the table here and what we expect out of him is nothing short of what he's been doing the last couple of days, or the last couple of games, that is.
And I guess you can say recently you guys have moved up Lichard with Gotinski and Steele. And talk about that line. Has that line kind of been what you guys have envisioned when you broke up the Lichard Musket Burke line that was going on so nicely for them?
Yeah, I think that line could actually give a little bit more. I know Gotinski really hasn't been producing much, but Steeler's been scoring consistently here the last 6-7 games. He's still been getting goals. I know he got a goal and an assist last game, and even a goal, I believe, in the Friday night against Corpus at home there too. So I think Steeler's just been doing his thing, and that whole Berkey, Lich, and Musket line was doing really well, and we just kind of wanted to bring a little bit more depth and development to Lichard with how young he is, and putting him with two age-out guys that really know how to play at this level really well, and hopefully our hope was for it to rub off on Lich, and I think it's been doing pretty well. Just as a whole, I think that line could give a little bit more though come game time and on their finishing touch on the plays.
I know that we've had a little bit of a travel problems or issues this week, so this week's been already weird. We have a Thursday night game. Talk about from the practices you've had this week, how has the team looked? Do you see any kind of sluggishness that maybe would come after a Christmas break?
Not too bad. I mean, like, we're already looking at Thursday, and since after Christmas we've hit the ice and had three practices, including pregame skate today. So I don't think our guys are gonna have any kind of excuse. I was really impressed with our first two practices back, how we were kind of just doing the right thing on the ice. I mean, yeah, you probably need to shake off some of the dust and stuff on passing and shooting, but the way that we were skating and just doing the little things right and positional stuff was really happy that the guys just kind of took off where they left off on from before the Christmas break.
Coach, thanks for the time and good luck tonight.
All right, thanks, Chet.
We'll have more after these messages here on the Landers Dodge Jeep Chrysler and Ram pregame show. You're listening to Shreveport Mudbugs Hockey.
Sterling Dental Center is a proud partner of the Shreveport Mudbugs. I'm Dr. Emil Janu, and my experienced staff and I will handle all your dental needs, from routine cleanings, x-rays, cavities, toothaches, and more, with the best and safest treatment out there. We are a family here at Sterling Dental Center, and we treat our patients like family. We welcome many forms of insurance. Come get your next dental appointment at Sterling Dental Center in Shreveport by calling 318-688-1040 or logging on to sterlingdentalshreveport.com.
You know, we only get one chance at this thing called life, so why don't we make it count? Hi, I'm Janice Watt with Generational Financial Advisors, and we're here to assist you as a financial advisor and a CPA in making those important life decisions. Starting young, saving, and investing will reward you down the road, but it takes diligence to stay the course because life happens. Buying that first home, adding to your family, and then preparing for college, all of these require a plan. We offer services including investments, life insurance, retirement planning, and long-term disability, just to name a few. We can also assist you in your tax preparation or planning along with small business services. We are an independent brokerage company with access to hundreds of products. Call me at 318-219-4188 or log into gfapartners.com to set up a free consultation. Our offices are located at 8518 Line Avenue, Suite 103 in Shreveport. Come see us and go Bugs.
Welcome back into a very loud American Bank Center. It's a great crowd filing in on a Thursday night in this fine facility in the South Division. It's now time for the Whataburger starting lineups. Whataburger, just like you like it. First for the Corpus Christi Ice Rays, head coach by Selene Cloutier. Assistant coach is Phil Oberlin. At left wing will be number 28, Anthony Caffarelli. At center will be number 19, Michael Casey. And on the right wing will be number 21, Cody Kempf. Defensively for the Rays, it'll be number 3, Leo Corris, and number 26, Owen Thomas. And making the start in nets, I thought he was impressive in some of the chances he had. He did good things for the Ice Rays. That'll be number 35, Thomas Kiesewetter. The numbers on Kiesewetter have been rough, though. He hasn't had much help in front of him. He's 4-9-3 with a 3.39 goals against and a 907 save percentage. Your Whataburger starting lineups for the Shreveport Mudbugs. Head coach by Jason Supik Campbell in his fifth year as the bench boss. Associate head coach Michael Hill, the assistant and goalie coach Rich Perrant, and the honorary assistant Chris Lane. At left wing will be number 24, Eric Vitale. At center will be number 25, Jaden Goldie. And on the right wing will be number 17, Drake Morris. Defensively for the Bugs, they're so glad to have him back after his upper body injury. Number 6, Maxim Sushinsky is back in the lineup. Great to have number 6 back there. Alongside will be number 4, Matthew Danziger, and making the start in nets. And boy, he's really taking a stranglehold on this number 1 goalie position is the man from Saint-Laurent, Montreal, number 44, Simo Bushler. And the numbers on Bushler don't really tell the story on how good he has been. He's 11-4-1 with a 1.98 goals against. That goals against top 5 best in the league, a 919 save percentage. He's got one shutout. He has won his last 6 straight starts in net. And it felt like there was a little bit of concern coming off the Christmas break going into this start. He told me this morning he wanted to get peppered by about 200 shots during morning skate. That's what happened, and then he said he felt good after his two-hour nap. So there you go. Those are your Whataburger starting lineups. Whataburger, just like you like it. Great crowd still filing in here into the American Bank Center. Mudbugs Hockey Tonight is brought to you by Porter's Industrial, delivering the difference in the Arc Latex for over 20 years. Porter's Industrial, with the utmost integrity to meet our customers' needs with quality uniform and facility services for your business. Mudbugs Hockey Tonight is also brought to you by Fireplace Specialties, a proud corporate partner of Mudbugs Hockey. Fireplaces, gas logs, glass doors, wood stoves, inserts, mantles, and grills, they got it all. They're located at 8500 Box Road in Shreveport, or by logging on to fireplacespecialties.net. Mudbugs will be back at home next weekend. Be sure to get your tickets. God and Goals themed on Friday, and Guns and Hoses on Saturday. All policemen and firefighters, if you're a member of the police department or a firefighter, you and your families get into the George's Pond at Hirsch Coliseum for free. The Mudbugs host the El Paso Rhinos. Be sure to get your tickets by giving us a call at 318-636-7094 or by logging on to ShreveportMudbugsHockey.com. We'll be back after these messages as you bring in the national anthem and the Landers opening puck drop. This is Shreveport Mudbugs Hockey.
As a business owner, you know it's important to stay ahead of your competition to succeed. One dishonest employee providing poor customer service can send your business to the penalty box. DeFatta & Associates has over 20 years of investigative experience that can help you monitor employees and investigate losses that may be keeping you from reaching your goals. Whether you need GPS tracking, investigative shopping, integrity testing, or you're experiencing losses caused by theft, DeFatta & Associates can help. Give them a call at 318-635-9944 or check out their website at DeFattaPI.com. For more information.
Sterling Dental Center is a proud partner of the Shreveport Mudbugs. I'm Dr. Emil Janu, and my experienced staff and I will handle all your dental needs, from routine cleanings, x-rays, cavities, toothaches, and more, with the best and safest treatment out there. We are a family here at Sterling Dental Center, and we treat our patients like family. We welcome many forms of insurance. Come get your next dental appointment at Sterling Dental Center in Shreveport by calling 318-688-1040 or logging on to sterlingdentalshreveport.com.
Welcome back into the American Bank Center in Corpus Christi, Texas. Mudbugs in their teal jerseys with the Mudbug head in front and the white numberings and letterings along the back. The Corpus Christi IceRays in their home whites with the Corpus Christi Stingray logo in front. The red numberings and letterings alongside the back. The Mudbugs will skate from right to left here in the Generational Financial Advisors first period. And what a Thursday night crowd this is at the American Bank Center. And that is just a testament to Cassidy Lang and his wonderful organization for putting on a Thursday night production. Now we ask that you please rise wherever you may be for tonight's national anthem before we get the Mudbugs and the IceRays kickstarted from the ABC. A wonderful rendition of tonight's national anthem by a local saxophonist here from the American Bank Center. Mudbugs winners of seven of their past eight And it has been led really up and down their lineup. They've had a lot of contributions from many different players, and they'll look to continue that this evening off the break. Of course, they welcome back Nick Lavassier and Maxim Sushinsky, a couple of guys that had a couple of upper body injuries. So glad to have them back in the lineup. But the Mudbugs without Hayden Nickel, he was not feeling well. From what I heard, he'll be back in town tomorrow. But without Hayden Nickel, it provides a little bit of a hole along the center role of things. The Mudbugs are going to have to go with Kaysen Musket, Ryan Burke, and Jake Mack. They call that the old helicopter line. No natural center. Three wingers, the old helicopter line between Musket, Burke, and Mack. And Hayden Nickel dearly missed not only on the ice but off the ice. One of the characters and leaders of this team. And we hope you are feeling better. We know he is tuned in tonight. We miss you, number 12. Jaden Goldie lined up with Michael Casey. The Landers opening puck drop, getting ready to be dropped. And the puck is dropped, battled and won there by Goldie. Fought off, and now puck swung in there along to the far corner there by number 21. That was Kempf. Now loose puck played up ahead there to Vitali. He'll fork it on over to Morris. Morris has it. He'll spin it back, thrown through this slot. Backhand shot, save made. Rebound chance. They score! It's Vitali! I believe Sushinsky got in there as well. They created traffic, and the Mudbugs have the game's opening goal just 20 seconds into this baby. Eric Vitali stays hot as he's got a point now in eight straight games. Boy, Eric Vitali attacked the net, and he gets rewarded with his fourth goal of the year. It should go Vitali from Morris. I don't know. Maybe Sushinsky. We'll see what the official helpers are on that one. We know Vitali got it. He's able to poke it home around the far side, and the Mudbugs continue right where they left off. Now a shot from the far corner. And that one gets deflected wide. The official call of the goal. Eric Vitali from Sushinsky and Morris just 22 seconds into this baby. I thought it was 20 seconds. We're going to have to get that changed. Boy, Eric Vitali with a point now in his last eight straight. There's a funny story about Vitali from the right point. Shot toward the net, gets blocked in front there by Brust. Along to the right point. Bugs with the early 1-0 lead. Now along to the far half wall. Here comes Burke. Wrist one toward the net. Save made. Oh, boy. It looked like Keysweater lost track of that. Now Musket. He'll poke it in deep there to Mack. This is the makeshift line without Nickel. Along to the near corner as Mack takes a hard hit. Musket on over to Burke. Burke now right back up top to Austin. Austin toward the net. Floating save. Rebound chance. A backhander. Oh, no. That's a big save made there by Keysweater. Another shot there from the far half wall by Zarski, is gloved down there by Keysweater. Play back out to center. Sushinsky trying to slide it through. Now taken away. And now here comes Kuznetsov. Good stick there by Danziger to knock it off his possession. Now on the far side, Lavassier poked it up ahead. Here comes Murray. Works it in fresh off the haircut. He throws it through the slot. It gets missed and played back out to center. Now taken there by Nielsen coming around the corner. Oh, backhand shot. Easy stick save made there by Bushler along to the far half wall. Mudbugs trying to grab it. Taken away there by Vitali. Vitali, he's got a man with him. It's Haru. Vitali snaps one toward the net. Save made there by Keysweater, and he'll hold on to it. Now, the thing about Eric Vitali is during this point streak of his, he has been eating raspberries every game. He had a little trouble getting his hands on some raspberries today. I don't know if he was able to obtain some. If he didn't, he's able to beat that, and he might need something else to keep him going. But it's been Raspberry Vitali for the last 7 to 8 games. We're not sure if he had a pack of raspberries today, but boy, he has been on fire right now. And the Mudbugs able to have an early 1-0 lead thanks to number 24. Now wristed off the near side boards. Dixon couldn't hold it in and goes all the way down. Now spun around. Uh-oh. Good job there by Haru to close up the gap. 1-0 lead early. Behind the Bugs net, off the stick, the left side of Vitali. He'll loft it all the way down. Goldie's going to go flag it down along to the far corner. He's got it now, thrown back up top to Zarski. Zips one toward the net. It gets blocked. Now from the top of the point, Austin wrists one toward. It was sticked away there by Keysweater. They call Eric Vitali Vito in the Mudbugs locker room. And Vito's hot. Shot there by Lichard. That one snapped just wide. Now Lichard behind the net. Played back. And now to Sushinski. Holds his own. Thrown across behind the stick of steel. And now played off the far side. Corpus able to ring it all the way down. Should be icing on Corpus Christi. And it is. Good start here for the Mudbugs. Almost 4 minutes in to the Generational Financial Advisors first period. For more information on planning your life's needs from college to retirement, you can call Ms. Janice Watt at 318-219-4188 or log on to gfapartners.com. I'm being notified some technical difficulties on the hockey TV side. We'll get that fixed as soon as we can. Continue to give me some feedback by messaging me to let me know if there's any more issues that fans are having. Everything was good before the game. Sometimes it has a nasty way of coming unglued once the game starts. Mudbugs hold the zone. Sushinski thrown back to Burke along the near corner. And now played back out. Here comes Kempf. Dropped off to Casey. Thrown across. And mishandled there by Caffarelli. Shot toward the net. Blocked in front there by Danziger. Now played up ahead, off the stick, too far there for Burke. Burke's going to join us in the second intermission. Burke's got it. Burke thrown through the slot, poked around. Now Haru in deep. He'll throw it in behind the cage. And now it's played back out along the far side there by Wanmacher, and he just kind of windmills it back into the Mudbug zone. Far side there to Murray. He'll twist it back out to center, played back in now. Along to the near side, that's Lewis. Lewis will leak it into the near corner. Along to that near corner it goes. It's Sushinski, or rather Haru, trying to grab it. On over to Marino. Marino along to the far corner there to Haru. Now banked back up top, up ahead there to Marino. Marino's got it. Marino outnumbered. He'll throw it now to the far side there to Fleet. Fleet centering feed got blocked in front there by Wanmacher. Along to the right side. Picked up there by Reimer. He throws it through the middle. It got blown up there by Goldie. Goldie cannot clear the zone. Uh-oh. And now Corpus Christi comes through. Shot gets blocked in front, and it's taken there by Fleet. Good block there by Zarski using his body. We hope everybody is doing okay. And we hope you're enjoying a Thursday night tilt from Corpus Christi. Yeah, I'm hearing some feeds are good, some feeds are not. Just bear down with us. And now played up ahead. And now far circle backhand shot there by Vitali. Whistles wide. Held in there by Danziger. Throws a shot. It was high. Now Litcher behind the cage. Litcher now thrown back up top to Danziger from the right point. He'll just trickle it in deep now. Behind the cage there is Mack. On over to Musket. Over to Litcher. Throws a shot toward the net, and it's smothered up there by Kiesewetter. And we got a break in the action with 13:19 remaining here in the opening period. Mudbugs hockey tonight brought to you by Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings BOGO Tuesday, Boneless Wings BOGO Thursday. Monday through Friday, happy hour 3 to 6. Buffalo Wild Wings, wings, beers, sports. What more do you want? Buffalo Wild Wings, a proud corporate partner of Mudbugs Hockey. We'll take a quick break and then bring you more Mudbugs Hockey after these messages. This is Shreveport Mudbugs Hockey.
You know, we only get one chance at this thing called life, so why don't we make it count? Hi, I'm Janice Watt with Generational Financial Advisors, and we're here to assist you as a financial advisor and a CPA in making those important life decisions. Starting young, saving, and investing will reward you down the road, but it takes diligence to stay the course because life happens. Buying that first home, adding to your family, and then preparing for college, all of these require a plan. We offer services including investments, life insurance, retirement planning, and long-term disability, just to name a few. We can also assist you in your tax preparation or planning along with small business services. We are an independent brokerage company with access to hundreds of products. Call me at 318-219-4188 or log into gfapartners.com to set up a free consultation. Our offices are located at 8518 Line Avenue, Suite 103 in Shreveport. Come see us and go Bugs.
Welcome back into the American Bank Center. We had play underway. Big save made there by Kiesewetter. Face off to the left of Kiesewetter. 1-0 lead for the Bugs on Vitali's fourth of the year from Sushinsky and Morris just 20 seconds into the game. Now along to the right side. Worked back in. Now taken away there by Mack. He'll float it up ahead there to Burke. Burke skates in now from the right side and snows one toward the net. Save made, rebound chance. They score! Jake Mack shovels home the rebound in front. Mudbugs 2, IceRays nothing. Bang, bang to get this baby started at the American Bank Center. Big start for the boys in teal, and they're up by 2. Boy, Jake Mack, just the man they've been looking for to get going. They want to get him heating up, and that's his 6th with a juicy rebound in front. Time of the goal. It comes at 7:06 of the first. It's the Mudbugs 2. The IceRays nothing. Ryan Burke picks up another apple, and boy, he is picking apples off a tree like taking candy from a baby. He's making it look easy. Now to the right point shot, whistles wide of Bushler. 2-0 lead. Once again, goals from Vitali and Macker, as they call him in the Mudbug locker room. Along to the left side, here comes Haru. He's looking for one. He comes around now along to the near corner, over to Goldie. And that puck deflects way out of the zone. Steele comes in fresh off the ice, or fresh off the bench. Boy, the Mudbugs with a quick start, and that's what they wanted. Now played up ahead, back into the Mudbug zone. Now back into the Corpus Christi zone. The IceRays have it. They'll lug it back out to center. Uh-oh, intercepted. Here comes Lavassier. Lavassier works it in. He'll spin it into the far corner. Marino's got it. Far half wall. He'll drop it off there to Danziger. Oh, whistles one toward the net. And that one got blocked in front. Boy, for Mac, it has been a slow start. And he knows that for him, that the time is now for him. We're around the midway point of the season. He knows he's got to pick it up. Didn't play too much hockey during the break. He wanted to clear his mind, spend a lot of time with his family. And big hello to the Max tuning in tonight from New Hudson, Michigan. Glad to have them with us. They kept up with their whole Christmas festivities, thanks to Miss Jennifer from New Hudson. Glad to have them all with us, all fine folks. Now along to the far corner. That's Mack. He'll throw it up ahead there to Musket. They'll lug it back out, and he'll just spill it back into the ice ray zone. And we got a whistle. Ryan Burke a bit perplexed on the whistle. Looks like it was an icing on the Bugs. Boy, big start here for the Bugs. Now thrown across from the point. Save made there by Bushler as Brust thrusts one toward the net from the point. For Simo Bushler, it was a very much needed Christmas break for him. He wanted a rest. Got a lot of ice time. Took a lot of shots and, of course, spent a lot of time with his mom and dad. Shot deflects wide as Brust threw one toward the net. Once again, Max sixth from Burke and Danziger at 7-0. That was 7-0-6. They said 7-0-9. Maybe my math is a little bit wrong on the time. Now behind Bushler's cage. Along to the left side, that's Austin. He'll leak it up ahead there to Zarski. Got a hurt ice ray now. Looked like a skate issue. And that is a tough situation for Grosick as he's got to get in to the bench as fast as he can. Stoppage of play, 9:53 to go here in the Generational Financial Advisors first period. Another one tonight between these two teams. It'll be a Friday night tilt. We'll hope to start it at 7:05 tomorrow night. It'll be a 6:50 Landers Dodge Jeep Chrysler and Ram pregame show. The finale of this two-game series. Faceoff was won there by the Ice Rays along to the right side. And it is needled in there by Wolfgang Govedaris, one of the great names in all of sports, or in all of the world, really. Along to the left side, now thrown across to the right side there to Wolfgang. He's got it thrown, shot toward the net, gloved away there by Gotinski. Gotinski avoids a hit, now taken there by Danziger. Danziger wants to lead the charge. And be able just to kind of smack it in down low now into the far corner. That's Gotinski getting help there by Steele along the far half wall. On over to Litcher, back to Steele. Steele from the right point. Tries to kind of rattle it into the slot. Now taken away. Here comes Lewis trying to split the D. He gets tripped up there by Haru. And the refs say no. Along to the left side. And, boy, Phil Oberlin is giving the officials an earful behind that Corpus Christi bench. A backhand shot blocked in front. Like I said, that Corpus Christi without Sylvain Cloutier. He is late. He'll be in here in the second period. A shot from the right point there by Dixon, smothered up there by Keysweater. And with 8:41 to go here in the Generational Financial Advisors first period, we have another break in the action. It's the Mudbugs 2, the Ice Rays nothing. This is Shreveport Mudbugs Hockey.
Sterling Dental Center is a proud partner of the Shreveport for routine cleanings, x-rays, cavities, toothaches, and more with the best and safest treatment out there. We are a family here at Sterling Dental Center, and we treat our patients like family. We welcome many forms of insurance. Come get your next dental appointment at Sterling Dental Center in Shreveport by calling 318-688-1040 or logging on to sterlingdentalshreveport.com.
Welcome back into the American Bank Center. The Mudbugs 2, the Ice Rays nothing. Be sure to stick around or join us, rather, for public skating. We have stick and puck the rest of this week from 4:15 to 5:45. We also have public skating going on at various times. You don't want to miss that. As the Mudbugs have a lot of opportunities for you guys to have a lot of fun on the ice. And now a right point shot gets blocked. Uh-oh, here's the other way. Here come the Ice Rays, throwing across, shovel, what a left pad save! Made there by Buechler! Gigantic save there by Buechler as he robbed Wanmacher from the short side. Oh, Simon Buechler, laissez le bon temps rouler, with a big time save as he quiets the crowd. Boy, that was thrown across. Wanmacher can't believe it. He is still looking up at what could have been. Like I said, public skating going on from 2 to 4 and 6 to 9 tonight. Of course, December 28th through the 31st, stick and puck come out to George's Pond, 4:15 to 5:45. You don't want to miss all those fun activities at George's Pond in Hirsch Coliseum. Buechler gets the first big save out of the way to get him loose along to the far corner. Deep now into the Ice Ray zone. 8 minutes to go here in the opening period. Someone got tripped up there. That was Danziger on that far half wall. Now to the right point. Getting shoved around there was Musket. He's going to keep going, though. Oh, boy. Musket lowered the shoulder. He was looking to take someone out now. Looked like an offside as Casey was coming around the left side. With 7:44 remaining here in the opening period. It's the Mudbugs 2, the Ice Rays nothing. A very fast start for Mudbugs hockey as Goldie takes the draw far Mudbugs blue line. Puck shoveled into the Mudbug zone there by Brust. On the far side there to Fleet. Uh-oh. Trying to be taken there by Haru. On over to Vitali along the left side there to Goldie. Goldie, oh boy, flips it out of play accidentally. Big hello to the Goldies. Tune in tonight from Owen Sound, Ontario. Glad to have them with us. Of course, Jaden Goldie's dad played a whole lot of professional hockey. Amy Baker tossing out souvenirs. She's going to be popular along that Mudbugs bench. She is popular. She's our beloved athletic trainer. Who runs a tight ship? She's got to in that job. Well, on the far half wall to the right of Buechler. Big hello to the Bakers, tuning in tonight from Indiana. Now to the top of the point. Uh-oh, space shot score. That's Wolfgang Govedaris. He had plenty of space, and Corpus Christi's on the board. Boy, that is a lot of time and space for Govedaris. I'm looking at the replay. Coach Soupy was not happy with all that time and space given up there. Boy, and that one looked easy. And that's probably the concerning thing about that goal given up. Dylan Contreras will get the only helper on Govedaris' goal. And we got a 2-1 game. For Govedaris, that's his first of the season. And that is a name you could market, Wolfgang Govedaris. Now behind the Ice Rays net, Mudbugs trying to get one back here. Here's Lichard. thrown back up top. Shot there by Danziger gets blocked. And it looked like it was touched by a high stick. And there's the whistle. 6:24 remaining here in the first period. Stick around for the Brookshire's Food and Pharmacy First Intermission Show. We'll talk to my roommate on the road, the equipment manager, Alexandre Sebastian Savage, better known as Alex Savage. I just like saying it the first way. It's got a little bit more gravitas, you know what I mean? Yeah, yeah, you with me? Maybe. Face-off won there by the Ice Rays. Now kicked around, puck poked back out to center. Lavassier on over to the near side there to Sushinski. And, boy, Sushinski couldn't get it in deep as it's taken away there by Grosick. He'll lead it to the far side there to Mum. Now along to the right side. Coming around now and couldn't get around in cleanly was Owen Thomas, and now we got a whistle. And it looks like we have a Mudbug penalty. Oh, boy, is this too many men? No, it's a kneeing infraction on Marino. But with 5:48 to go here in the first period, Mudbugs facing some adversity now. Mudbugs power penalty kill, rather, very good. They're fourth best in the league, just behind Amarillo at 87%. Corpus Christi's power play, 21st at 16.5%. First choice personnel penalty kill on the ice. Face-off won there by the Rays. They have it. That's Reimer. Reimer has it. He'll drop it off up top there. Rebound chance. Got swiped just wide. That was Wanmacher in front. Brooks trying to clear it along into that near corner. Got a little bit of a traffic jam there as Austin lost his helmet. And now... oh, good job there by Danziger. Going to cut off the lane over to Morris. Morris now going to work it in. Morris coming around the corner. Morris has got a shot here through the slide. That was Danziger. And now Morris shot toward the net gets blocked. And now along to the near corner. Good job there by Gotinski killing off some more precious seconds. Now along to the right side. Worked back into Reimer. We're down to a minute left on the man advantage. Intercepted there by Sushinski. And he's able to slice it right back into the neutral zone. Coming right back in, though, is Caffarelli. Thrown through slot shot. Save made. Rebound chance. Right pad save. And there's a whistle. Boy, there was traffic. The net came off its mooring. And that's a break for the Mudbugs. As they had Bushler juking and jiving along that short side. .432 remaining here in the opening period. The Bugs 2, the Rays 1. Face-off one there by the Bugs. Haru's got it. Haru now along to the right side. Haru's going to gallop across. Now the red line, now the blue line. He comes in coast to coast. Backhander gets blocked. Now Haru will take it around. He'll throw it back, and the Mudbugs will kill off some more precious seconds. Morris to the far side there to Fleet. And Fleet now off the stick of Goldie, and Goldie will just go ahead and slip it in to the Ice Rays zone. One last chance on this man advantage for the Ice Rays. Along to the right side, here's Caffarelli. Drop back on over to Corpus. Corpus now to the far side. Across, shot, save made. Rebound chance, and that was Casey who got smothered up on the rebound chance. Thrown across. Now they tic-tac-toe. It shot toward the net. Glove down there by Bushler on a shot there by Corpus as the penalty expires. I think both teams got to be happy with their special teams on that one. It looked like the Ice Rays had some good looks at it. Michael Casey with some heated words toward the lead official. He never stops jabbing at the officials. We remember him. Former Mudbug for a little bit. I saw him before the game. We hugged for a minute, talked. Good to catch up just a bit with him. Along to the left side, Zarski up ahead off the stick of Marino. Now in front of that ice race bench, Marino getting spun around as he's able to twist it into the Mudbugs zone. No, shot toward the net, the Mudbugs offensive zone rather. And oh, Marino poked it just wide. There was a loose puck. Now played back out to center, held up a little bit. Taken down there was Murray. Now along the left side, blocked there by Marino. It ricochets back out to center. 3:10 remaining here in the first. Played back in. Here's Perillo. Gage Perillo sandwiched in along the back there by Danziger. Danziger's got a good look and good hold of him as Vitali able to wrist it all the way down. Icing waved off. Taken there by Hintz, and Hintz will slowly park it behind the raised net and gallop across now from left to right. Along to the near side. Kicked around there by Sushinsky. Up ahead. There to Vitali. Coming around now. Good move. Vitali holds the zone and now taken back out there by Lewis. Back out to center. Good stick there by Morris. Taken there by Vitali. Vitali coming around. Battling for it. Vitali. Far circle. Fires one toward the net. It got blocked in front. Now played back out to center. Puck now wristed toward the net. It's gloved down there by Bushler with 2:21 remaining here in the opening period. Shreveport 2, Corpus Christi 1. Face off to the right of Bushler. Face off one there by the Ice Rays. Spun around there is Kuznetsov. Now kicked around there by Dixon. He's a big body to get around. It's like a lumberjack out there. Now behind the Mudbucks net. Official almost got in the way, and he almost got sandwiched. Now Musket leads it up ahead there for his buddy Burke. Burke comes into the zone. Burke now with a little space. Burke's got an assist tonight. And centering fee gets blocked, and now Musket down low. Mudbucks trying to grind one down low with some help there from Mack. The old helicopter line, no natural center, all three wingers. Now Mack along the left side. Oh, mishandled there by Musket. Had a little too much speed on it. Now along to the far corner, battling for it. Boy, Musket battling. Now along to the near corner. How many times have we said that this season? Along to the far side. Here's Kuznetsov. Coming around into the middle. Kind of got slowed down there by Musket. Now taken there by Zarski. Looks along his back over to Gotinski. Now over to Austin. Austin going to lug it back out to center over to Steele. And Steele will just dump it in. He's got Lichard in on pursuit. Now along to the near corner. Play back out to center. Sushinsky will be able to chip it back into the ice ray zone. Less than a minute to go here in the opening period. Mudbugs with a one-goal lead. Through the middle now. Here comes Caffarelli. Drop back through the slot. Shot shoveled toward the net. And it's a glove save made there by Bushler on a shot there by Casey cutting through the high slot. Mudbugs have had some travel adventures this week. They were supposed to leave Shreveport Tuesday night. They had a problem with the bus. Ended up leaving Wednesday afternoon, late afternoon. They arrived at their hotel. Really today, it was 12:30 at night when they arrived. But everybody slept good on the bus. Everybody slept good in the hotel. And had a good morning skate, and they felt really good going into tonight's game, considering the circumstances. Goldie able to yank it up ahead, but it's taken away there by Hintz. Now loose puck, last chance here maybe for the Bugs. Danziger to the far side there to Morris. Morris now throbs it up ahead there to Vitali, 15 seconds to go. Now over to Oleksiy Donikovsky. Donikovsky now to the far side. Good stick there by Fleet. And Fleet now getting manhandled a little bit there by Caffarelli. Fleet didn't seem to mind, and we're right back into the ice ray zone, and that'll do it for the first period. The Mudbugs will take a 2-1 lead after one, with goals from Vitali and Mack. And for Vitali, he now has a point in 8 straight games. And stick around for the Brookshire's Food and Pharmacy First Intermission Show. We'll talk to the Mudbugs' newest equipment manager after these messages.
Hey, this is Chet Yoder, voice of the Mudbugs. DeFada & Associates Investigative and Risk Analysis Services has been conducting professional private investigations for over 20 years. They offer a full range of services to both individuals and businesses. Whether you need an investigator for a personal matter, like a child custody case, or you suspect an internal theft problem with your business, DeFada & Associates has the experience, training, and knowledge to get you the information you need. Call Jerry today at 318-635-9944 to talk about your case, or visit them online at defadapi.com.
You know, we only get one chance at this thing called life, so why don't we make it count? Hi, I'm Janice Watt with Generational Financial Advisors, and we're here to assist you as a financial advisor and a CPA in making those important life decisions. Starting young, saving, and investing will reward you down the road. But it takes diligence to stay the course because life happens. Buying that first home, adding to your family, and then preparing for college, all of these require a plan. We offer services including investments, life insurance, retirement planning, and long-term disability, just to name a few. We can also assist you in your tax preparation or planning along with small business services. We are an independent brokerage company with access to hundreds of products. Call me at 318-219-4188 or log into gfapartners.com to set up a free consultation. Our offices are located at 8518 Line Avenue, Suite 103 in Shreveport. Come see us and go Bugs!
The Robertson Cup champion Shreveport Mudbugs know big goals lead to big wins. That's why State Farm agent Ben Tolis and his State Farm team are here to help you score a big goal with your home and auto insurance. It's a great call that saves you time and money. So go score the winning goal and score savings by combining your home and auto. It's just another way we're here to help your life go right. Call State Farm agent Ben Tolis today at 318-688-1522. That's 318-688-1522.
Welcome back into the Brookshire's Food and Pharmacy First Intermission Show here from the American Bank Center in Corpus Christi. We're joined by my roommate, the one, the only. He does the hardest job, I think, probably behind the scenes that you could ever have in hockey. The one, Alexandre Sebastian Savage. Did I say that right?
Yeah, you did.
Okay. You sometimes when I want your full correct pronunciation, you don't want to give it to me. Are you ashamed of your full name?
I'm not ashamed of my full name. It's just I'm not very good at speaking in a French accent or French words. So it comes out a little funny sometimes.
Of course, better known as Alex Savage, equipment manager of the Shreveport Mudbugs. Talk about this experience and how it's gone for you so far. We're kind of around the midway point of this season.
It's been great. It was kind of a struggle at the beginning, getting to learn everything new, never having experience doing this kind of stuff. But the more we get into the season, the more comfortable I get and the better I get at all those skills that I've developed.
How did you kind of gain interest in this position? I know you played hockey at ETBU, so obviously you're familiarized there, but to be an equipment manager, it's a different role.
Yeah, well, so I was going to school for, like, sports management. I was trying to get into sports somehow. And I was here during the summer and decided that I wasn't going to go back to ETBU, and Scott Musket asked me, do you want to be the equipment manager of the Shreveport Mudbugs? And so, I mean, it's always been my dream to work for a hockey team, and this was a step to get there. And so I took it.
And obviously now you've done a good job about it. Talk about the hardest part of this job, because it feels like there's a million things going on in your world, and that's like a million things not going on in my world, which is good because I don't think I can tackle it. But talk about probably the hardest part of your job, that if there is a challenging part.
Just keeping up with everything, keeping everything like scheduled and having everything organized, making sure everything needs to, or everything is where it needs to be. Like, I have to get up here at a certain time, and then at 10 minutes from me getting here, this has to be done. And then every 10 minutes, something else has to be done. It's just getting the process down is probably the most difficult part.
And I know every year is a different group of guys, and you've been a hockey player, so you know what it's like to be on that other perspective of what a hockey player needs or wants. Has this team been needy? You know, sometimes they can be a little bit where they're, you know, busting down your door because they know where you're at, looking for things or needing things.
No, these guys aren't too bad. I mean, there's a couple of guys, the one or two that always shout my name, maybe every hour or so, trying to get something from me. But other than that, I think the guys pretty much know that I'm busy and they do whatever they can to help me so I can do everything I can to help them.
Is this a field that you want to move up in, or is this something where you just want to see where it goes? Kind of, have you ever like even thought about it, or is it still too early for that?
I'm still kind of seeing where it goes. I mean, I'm enjoying it right now, but the traveling and stuff is something I need to get used to. But I feel like I'll be back next year and maybe a year after that at least.
And of course, I mean, you're the son of Ale Savage, of course, former great Mudbug, and of course, current ETBU coach of hockey and lacrosse. Talk about the impact he's had on your life just overall. I mean, from playing hockey to now becoming an equipment manager, and talk about what it's like to be the son of him, because from what we see of him now, he's like the madman behind the ETBU bench just screaming his lungs out.
Savvy. My dad is probably one of the only reasons that I've played hockey. He's just such an inspiration for me to try and come out and do my best every day, because I know that if he were in my same position, he would do exactly the same thing. And he's probably one of the only reasons that I'm here right now.
And, of course, playing hockey at ETBU, talk about that experience. I mean, that's obviously a fulfilling experience for you to be able to do that.
Oh, it was so awesome. It was such a great experience to go with, like, to meet all these new people. And then, like, after a couple of weeks, I consider my brothers. Like, there's some of them are still some of my best friends, even though I haven't seen them. It was such a great experience. It really changed my outlook on, like, trying to meet new people and getting to do different new things.
We're talking to Mudbugs equipment manager Alex Savage here in the Brookshire's Food and Pharmacy First Intermission Show. Talk about the road trips. Are they a little bit harder of a grind there as far as just your world as opposed to home games, just so people can kind of get a perspective?
Home games are a lot more work than traveling, but traveling is a lot more exhausting than home games. Home games, I get to sleep in my own bed.
Right.
And so I get a good night's sleep. A little bit. Yeah, it's just the traveling is good, but it's exhausting.
Coach Soupy wanted to know, how much can he pay you to destroy your pillow? So, because you have a Montreal Canadiens pillow cover, and obviously he's a Toronto guy. He's more of a Maple Leafs, Islanders kind of guy. He wants to know, is there a price he can pay you to destroy that?
No, never.
And you've had that since birth.
Yeah, since 6 months years old, I've had the same pillowcase. Yeah,
and it's still able to fit in the pillow because it's a smaller pillowcase because you're obviously a smaller human being.
Yeah, it still fits. Every pillow that I've gotten so far has fit inside of it.
Does it have sentimental value?
A little bit of sentimental value. Just a little bit.
You also have like a really cool blanket too. Talk about that.
Oh my god!
Because at first I thought it was a little nerdy and geeky, but obviously that one has maybe even the same kind of significant value.
Talking about that one.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's so I've been dating my girlfriend for 5 years now, maybe almost six now.
Oh, you guys are like married now at this point.
Pretty much. But she got me this blanket whenever we first started dating, and I still use it every day, and I bring it with me on every road trip. Yeah.
What is your best memory on this blanket? Because I'm looking at it right now. You have, you're smaller. I won't lie. You've got shorter hair. You've dressed up. I've never seen you really dressed up all that much in some of this. Do you have a favorite memory on this blanket?
At Hot Wheels roller rink on there somewhere. First time that meet stuff like that. So I think that's probably my favorite memory on the blanket.
It's very neat. I mean, and it's good that the relationship has worked out, because I don't want to even imagine, you know, what kind of reimbursement she might have asked for this, because this is a lot of work right now. It is. Before I close out, I got to put you on the spot. Who's your favorite Mudbug?
I can't answer that question. Come on, they're gonna listen to this, and they're definitely gonna say something if I name one player. I like all the players.
Who's in a joking manner the most difficult Mudbug?
The most difficult. So the person who calls my name the most is Sutton Murray.
Okay, I knew it.
And
okay.
Then after that, it's probably Ryan Burke. Just sometimes he just rubs me the wrong way.
Savage Alexander Sebastian Savage. Thank you so much for the time, and good luck, and enjoy the rest of the season.
Thank you.
We'll have more after these messages here on the Brookshire's Food and Pharmacy First Intermission Show. You're listening to Shreveport Mudbugs Hockey.
You know, we only get one chance at this thing called life, so why don't we make it count? Hi, I'm Janice Watt with Generational Financial Advisors, and we're here to assist you as a financial advisor and a CPA in making those important life decisions. Starting young, saving, and investing will reward you down the road, but it takes diligence to stay the course because life happens. Buying that first home, adding to your family, and then preparing for college, all of these require a plan. We offer services including investments, life insurance, retirement planning, and long-term disability, just to name a few. We can also assist you in your tax preparation or planning along with small business services. We are an independent brokerage company with access to hundreds of products. Call me, EFAPartners.com, to set up a free consultation. Our offices are located at 8518 Line Avenue, Suite 103 in Shreveport. Come see us and go Bugs.
Sterling Dental Center is a proud partner of the Shreveport Mudbugs. I'm Dr. Emil Janu, and my experienced staff and I will handle all your dental needs, from routine cleanings, x-rays, cavities, toothaches, and more, with the best and safest treatment out there. We are a family here at Sterling Dental Center, and we treat our patients like family. We welcome many forms of insurance. Come get your next dental appointment at Sterling Dental Center in Shreveport by calling 318-688-1040 or logging on to sterlingdentalshreveport.com.
Welcome back into the American Bank Center. It was a great start for Mudbugs hockey. Goals from Eric Vitale and Jake Mack early in the first. And then at 12:51, the Ice Rays responded with Wolfgang Govedaris ripping home his first of the year. The score 2-1 after one, second period coming up, and it's brought to you by DeFatta and Associates, Investigative and Risk Analysis Services, personal matters, child custody cases, internal theft problems within your business. Just call our main man, Jerry DeFatta, at 318-635-9944 to talk about your case or log on to DeFattaPI.com. I want to give a big special thanks to our Claws-Up Booster Club. Not only do they do so many great things during our games, they do a lot of great things with our guys off the ice, and they are able to supply us with funds to eat a team lunch, get snacks, get waters. Big thanks to Carl Phillips, Leanne Bechtel, and the rest of the amazing Claws-Up Booster Club. If you want to be a Claws Up Booster Club member, all you got to do is just give us a call at 318-636-7094. Second period underway as the puck is banked into the Mudbug zone to my left. Mudbug skate from left to right here in the second period. Puck right back into the Ice Rays zone. Mudbugs would love to duplicate the start they had in the first period here in the second. Kicked in off the skate of Vitale. Now Morris in pursuit, played back out, and ripped back into the Ice Rays zone there by Vitale. Big hello to the Vitales, tuning tonight from Markham, Ontario. I'm sure they're enjoying it. Right back into the Mudbug zone as Fleet's got it along the far side. The mile-high kid coming around the far corner. He might be fresh off a new suit. He had a very spiffy-looking suit coming onto the bus today. That was quite impressive. I don't know if I could pull it off, but he certainly did. Shot toward the net. That one deflected wide on a shot from the right point there by Haru. Played back out to center. That was Fleet off the far side, up ahead there to Gotinski, and he'll tap it in. The Macomb, Michigan native coming around that far corner, trying to get some help there by Litchard. Held in there by Steele. Thrown through the slot behind Gotinski. And now carried back out. Here's Wanmacher around to the far side. Good hip check there, and he slowed up in its tracks there by Austin. Held in there by Brust. He'll bang it in down low. It goes to the near corner. On over to Govedaris. Spun around now behind the Mudbugs net. Taken there by Austin. Kicks it around a little bit. He'll chip it up ahead, trying to find Gotinski. Now played back to Zarski. Zarski's got to go all the way back behind the Shreveport net off the far side window as he's able to wing it all the way down. Should be icing on the Bugs, and it will be. Zarski had to go all the way up to Edmonton, Alberta to celebrate what was a very snow-filled Christmas for him, but that's nothing new. Big hello to the Zarskis tuning tonight from the aforementioned Edmonton. Zarski, of course, a diehard Edmonton Oilers fan. So he naturally thinks they are close. They got some of the best players in the world. Here comes through the slot. Here's Steele. Fired one. He scores! The captain right through the slot rifles that baby home. 2-12, Tom of the goal, the second, with his seventh goal in his last eight games. Boy, Garrett Steele continues to light the lamp at a rapid pace as he found some space and he gets his team-leading 12th of the year. Boy, not much on that one. Went right through the wickets of Key Sweater. And for Garrett Steele, he's got a goal in his last three games. Great work from Garrett Steele. And boy, I said it in our last broadcast, that is a guy the rest of the league does not want to see start to heat up. And Steele, who's had very many nicknames, but the one that's been dawning me is they've been calling him the Animal in Mudbug Nation. And the Animal's on the loose in his final year as a Mudbug. Big goal for him.